A warm welcome to all of you to my channel Gear to Action. I, Pradeep, would like to thank all of you for like, sharing and subscribing to our YouTube channel. In today's topic, we'll discuss about boiler combustion and equipment. TDR, turndown ratio. Boiler turndown ratio is the ratio of maximum heat output to the minimum level of heat output at which the boiler will operate efficiently or controllably. TDR of a burner indicates flexibility of the burner to cope up with the variation of boiler loads without losing efficiency of the combustion. So it should be able to work irrespective of any load and any variation of the boiler load. The TDR is fuel consumed at maximum load to the fuel consumed at minimum load. Indications of a good combustion. The flame should be bright color, yellow for gas oil, orange for diesel oil, brownish orange for HFO. Stability, the flame should be steady and stationary. Hazy gray or hazy brown color adjust. O2 content, if tanker fitted with IGS less than 5%. Boiler combustion and MARPOL regulations. As of 1st January 2020, amendments to MARPOL brought in a global sulfur cap of 0.50%. The MARPOL Emission Control Area, ECA, limit of 0.10% will still apply, as will any applicable local regulations. NOx technical code only apply on A and not in boiler. Continuous emission of black smoke is prohibited. Advantage of vertically mounted burner over horizontally mounted burner. Vertically mounted burner are easier to remove and assemble. They are easy to alignment. Lesser chances of flame impingement. Due to space consideration and layout of engine room, marine boilers tend to be vertically tight. Because of this high capacity, burners are vertically mounted in order to achieve longer flame propagation. Action required in case burner fails to fire repeatedly. What all actions is required when your burner is not firing and is getting flame off? For every failed attempt, furnace must be purged properly. Please do purge the furnace properly. Maximum 2 or 3 attempts to be made. After that, burner to be shut down for thorough investigation. If you are not able to fire the boiler in 2 to 3 attempts, please check the problem. What is exact problem? Rectify that, and then you can keep trying, but you should not try more than 2 to 3 times, because you will start accumulating oil in the furnace bottom. So furnace to be checked for oil accumulation. burner types: pressure jet burners, steam blast burner, rotary cup burner, and ultrasonic burner. This is a cross-sectional drawing for the pressure jet burner. You can see atomizing orifice, swell chamber, swell plate, swell port, locking screw for the burner, oil supply port, boiler furnace housing, barrel carrier, and cap nut. And this one here is a swirler. How does it look like? So this is exploded cross-sectional view of a pressure jet burner. Now we will discuss about the working principle of this type of burner. Working principle: atomization of jet is achieved by forcing the fuel oil under pressure through the swirler plate and orifice at the end of the burner. Pressure energy is converted into the velocity. Spinning of oil is given by swirler before orifice and by the centrifugal force causing it to atomize. Advantage and disadvantage of pressure jet burners. So first we'll discuss advantages. Simple, cheap, and robust. No moving parts, so there is no possibilities of seizing. No need of air or steam for atomization. Simple in maintenance. And what all the disadvantages? Low TDR, turndown ratio is very low, that is about 3:1, and easily blocked by debris, so your orifice might get clogged due to the carbonization or by the fuel carrying debris if your fuel quality is not good. This is again a cross-sectional drawing for the steam ballast burner. Here you can see the cap nut, boiler casing, atomizing nozzle, flame stabilizer, oil inlet port, steam inlet port, purging wall in between these two ports, and steam, safety steam cutout wall. The various types, different types of nozzles. This is waist, and the other one is this one is the down, bottom one is the tangential. Steam pressure is about 10 bar. Oil pressure is 3 to 20 bar, depending on the load. So now we see the working principle of steam ballast burner. This type of burner is similar in working as pressure jet, with an addition of high pressure steam supplying arrangement incorporated in it. The oil is thus spread in the path of this high pressure air or steam, which helps the fuel for atomization. Normally, air is used during initial starting of the burner, then steam take over the operation. A convergent divergent nozzle is used to convert the pressure energy into the kinetic energy, which results in a high velocity jet of steam, which enables atomization of a fuel oil spread in the path. The steam side have tangential nozzle, which provides a rotary motion of the fuel oil to ensure efficient combustion. So Stimbalas that burn advantage and disadvantages. Advantages, TDR high, 20:1, and disadvantage, if condensate is mixed in steam, performance is very poor and causes unstable combustion. This is a cross-sectional view of a rotary cup burner. It's a drawing. So you can see swirler, rotary cup, air vent, primary air nozzle, combustion air inlet, wind box through which the combustion air comes, igniters, motor, and the motor can be, the burner can be then a gear driven or a bell driven depending on the design. So shaft supporting bearing, and primary air flap, and this is fuel oil supply and combustion air from the bottom also. This cup should be outside little bit, 1 to 2 mm. So let's see the working principle of this type of rotary cup burner. Fuel is supplied into inner surface of highly spinning cup around 2000 to 6000 rpm. Due to centrifugal force, oil film becomes thinner as cup circumference increases due to conical shape of cup. Finally, fuel is discharged from lip of cup on fine spray, widely popular due to wider turn down ratio. Rotary cup burner advantages and disadvantages. So what all are the advantages? Good atomization of heavy fuels. Turn down ratio for this burner is 15:1. Low preheat temperature of the fuel oil required for atomization. No high pressure fuel in the line. Disadvantages. Complex in construction. Costly to maintain. This one is a ultrasonic burner. You have a resonance tip, oil holes, steam inlet and oil inlet. The working principle for this type of ultrasonic burner is ultrasonic burner working principle. Resonance tip vibrates at a frequency 5 MHz to 20 MHz under the influence of high speed steam or air impinging on it, and extremely small droplets of fuel results which allow very stable flame. Advantage: wide TDR 15:1, low O2 level, simple operation, reduce acid corrosion, essential maintenance on burners. The following maintenance to carry out on burners. The nozzle atomizing holes should be checked for sign of enlargement, which can lead to bad combustion. Chiller place to inspect for erosion, corrosion. The ignition electrodes clearance to be checked for efficient flame establishment during startup. Waste heat recovery system. Difference between EGE and EGB, exhaust gas economizer and exhaust gas boiler. EGE, circulation, heated up and returned to auxiliary boiler. EGB, steam storage capacity and full set of mountings. Pinching point. What is pinching point? Pinch point. In principle, pinch point may be considered a measure of how extensive and how efficient the heat utilization of the exhaust gas boiler waste heat recovery system. Temperature differential between temperature of incoming water and outgoing exhaust. Temperature differential at evaporation usually used as a guide for efficient heat transfer across the tube, that is temperature in minus temperature out is temperature of exhaust gas. Pressure differential of exhaust gas across the tube stack. The higher the pinch point, the longer the heat transfer surface, and the more efficient is the waste heat recovery system, exhaust gas boiler. Factors to achieve pinch point. Exhaust gas pressure loss and gas velocity. To achieve maximum heat transfer, the tube stack arrangement has to be optimized. This will lead to a higher pressure loss and corresponding reduction in gas velocity. Limitations. Too much pressure drop may adversely affect main engine operation, that's for example TC surging. Too low gas velocity has a tendency of soot deposit accumulation. Low exhaust gas outlet temperature below the dew point can lead to sulfuric acid corrosion. And dew point sulfur content into exhaust gas temperature. As a chief engineer to achieve pinch point. Soot blowing, water washing, good purification, good combustion of main engine. Bunker must meet engine specifications. Regular boiler water treatment. Hope you like this video and it might be helpful to you. Thank you. Thanks for watching.